Okay, so welcome again to Web Applications for Everybody. We're doing a bit of code walkthrough. Right now we're in, talking about the forms topic. And so what I want to talk about is this model view controller pattern. But I'm start with some code that sort of I've used before, this guess code, guess.php, where we're supposed to guess a play a guessing game. Guess equals 14. It's, oops, I did a minus sign there. Guess is too low. So I want to take a look at this code. And so this is kind of a typical crude basic PHP script, a bit disorganized. It starts with some HTML because that's what they are, is it's a template, and it drops into PHP and then does some logic and then puts a bunch of echo statements. And what it does do well is its structure overall, top to bottom, is not what I like. And I'll show you in a second how I want to restructure it. But it does do a pretty good job of, you know, checking to see if there's a guess parameter and complaining if there's not, checking to see if the guess is too short. This is all input validation that's doing a pretty good job of. In my next application, I'll have it better structured, but I won't do this validation. And then once I know, by the time it gets to here, I know that I've got at least sane data. It's a number, it's the right length, and it exists. And then I can say if it's too low or too high. And otherwise, if it's equal, then I say congratulations. So this is nice little error checking here, and nice structure with else ifs. I like that. But the fact that I just sort of like intermingle my PHP with my HTML gets a little bit sort of confusing after a while. And so, and this is not either the greatest application, but it demonstrates quickly and simply this notion of what I call, well, what the world calls model view controller, and this is my really simple implementations of model view controller. You can go Google model view controller, and you can view controller, and you can read so much stuff about model view controller. Oh, I even use that slide in my talk. And the whole idea of model view controller is that when you're doing the request response cycle, there are three basic things that happen. One is the data model gets updated, the database, the backend, etc. You generate a new page, and there's this thing called the controller, which decides what to do with the model data, what next screen to pick, how to respond to the incoming post data. And so I would call it controller model view rather than model view controller. And that's kind of like the picture that Wikipedia is showing you here. And you can read and read and read and read and read more about model view controller, and there's whole frameworks that do model view controller. But what I do to keep it simple so that you know model view controller in kind of this low level sense, and then when you move to a framework that's more advanced, then you can just use the framework to do all the model view controller magic. So in model view, so this is kind of like the model. And so what I do is I always start my PHP files that are going to do data processing in PHP, not in HTML. And the model is handling the incoming data. And the view, there's always a line in every one of my scripts where you see, oh, I've switched from the model to the view, at least the ones that process data. So above the line, the idea is you talk to databases and do your data processing and handle post data. And below the line, you just mostly generate output. That doesn't mean that you don't sneak a little PHP in here, because PHP is both a programming language and a templating language. And in this case, I'm just deciding if the message is not false, print it, or print out the old value in the form using the HTML entities and the less than question mark equal for the echo. So the idea is there's always this line above which we are completely silent and below which we don't do any major data operations. We can do loops and whatever, but we don't talk to the database, we don't do that thing. And so that's my discipline. And controller is the whole script. And if we get later in more sophisticated things, we'll see that we're doing routing decisions. We're sometimes moving, after we process the data, we send them to a different script. And so orchestration and routing is the function of controller. So this guessing game, GuessMVC, this GuessMVC is going to look like every other guessing game we've made. So if I say 12, now it's a post. If you look, it's going to be a post, so it's not going to show up here. So the old guess was 12, and it says too low, and guess is 12. Okay, and then I can change it, 123, it's too high. How about 121? So all this stuff is working. But if you look at it, what's happening is old guest, if and a get request, so let me do a get request by just hitting it and hitting enter. So I do a get request. There is nothing in post, so old guess is false and message is false. And there is a thing that's passed between the model and the controller, and the model and the view. I call that the context. And that's really, in this case, it's just two variables. Old guess and message are set and then fall into the template, passed into the template. In other frameworks, we're more explicit about constructing a context and rendering a template with that context. But I'm keeping it really simple by saying context is what falls through from here to here. And we have to do it in a get request because it's going to run these two lines of code and then skip all the way down to here. So old guess is nothing and message equals false. And that's why there is no guess here and there's no message. But then when I say 12 and I hit a post request, it is going to be, this is going to become true. And now there's no error checking. I'm sorry. I'm trying to keep this simple so it fits on a screen. So error checking would go up here. This is actually the logic of the guessing game. I'm just converting this to an integer by adding a zero to it. That's kind of quick and dirty. And then I'm checking to see if it's 42 or less than 42. But what I'm doing is I'm not putting echo statements here. I'm setting the message and then letting it fall through into the template. So there'll be silence up here. There'll be a bit of silent work that you don't even see up here where message and old guess are being set right here. And then it falls in and then it renders it and away you go. And so that's the basic idea of model view controller. And we'll talk about this a bunch, especially when we have more interesting stuff to just looking at the guess. And especially when this we get like 2 to 3 pages of code up here, it's important to really mentally separate the brains of your code from the look of the code. So model at the top, view at the bottom. Okay? So I hope that has been helpful to you. See you on the net.